Hello there, folks, and welcome back to Control. We're in the dimensional research area, and there's a lot of sand. For some reason, my microphone, I think I must have changed the angle of my camera or something because it's picking up my microphone. I haven't changed the position of the mic much. Right, anyway. Let's see what this sand is all about. We've restarted the computer. Obviously, for you guys, it's a new day. If you've been following along.
There was a doorway here. To where Dylan and I went, where the projector took us, where we met you. The Bureau opened the same door here, but there's just an echo now. Just on the other side?
Yeah, we're not being able to go forward. So, Polaris is, as we know, a paranormal entity. Something from another dimension. This is all just a projection. There's nothing actually here. Stand away from frame when emergency lights are on. Thing? Levitation ammo efficiency. Right, will the lift work now? No. So we must be able to reach one of these. Gantries then. Yeah, we can reach that one, can't we? Are we flying up here? Yes, we are. And heading over to... Oop. Heading over to the other side, which we almost screwed up easily. But the projector is not here. I'm assuming that's where it's supposed to be.
The projector's not here. Moved again. What did Darling do with it? I've got to find out.
But in that case, why did we see all that stuff? Or was that just Polaris?
Slidescape 36 bears deep wave marks. On the slide and in the distance, there's a formation of five pillars like crude, outstretched fingers. There were casualties on our first expedition. Communication is an issue. There is no sound there, as if you've gone deaf, and radios don't work. Correction, a resonance from an unknown source in part within the range of audible frequency. It acts in unpredictable ways, causing feedback loops that can tear you apart. Trench insists he heard something else. It made his ears bleed. Our equipment found no evidence of anything beyond the primary resonance. Trench's medical tests show nothing amiss.
For demonstration purposes only, not the actual object of power.
The projected image from each slide is a physical portal into another dimension. Only one slide remains. Dylan's sister burned the rest in ordinary before we could intercept. The text on it, color slide film, this side towards screen, and the number 36. The topography of slidescape 36 bears deep wave marks. On the slide and in the distance, there's a formation of five pillars.
But I'm wondering... No, that's the wrong button. Because sometimes these are different.
The projected image from each slide is a...
No, that's the same. So, yeah, what has Darling done with the projector? And more importantly, why has he done what he's done with the projector? That didn't work. Because we have yet to see Dr. Darling... What is his obsession? Oh, I can't aim or anything here. What is his obsession with these cube patterns and designs? And why does Jesse keep holding her shoulder? Hedron containment. Hedron and the Hedron resonance are arguably the greatest assets this bureau has ever possessed. The security of Hedron is unspeakably vital, which is why we have blah, blah, blah from the majority of Bureau employees. This report details the containment procedures required for the Hedron containment chamber, including details on the being pumped into the containment cell, mechanical upkeep of the resonance siphons, and the arrangement of the acoustic pillars to dampen or amplify the sonic range of the chamber. So, Hedron and the resonance are a physical thing, or a metaphysical, potentially, thing. That they have contained, and they're amplifying its resonance, which stops the hiss. I am really really bad at those. There we go.
Expedition 3. We located the source of the resonance in Slidescape 36. It is an entity, a living organism of a considerable mass. I've named it Hedron based on its physical shape.
Hedron?
We built a container for it.
You? Did he bring you here? Is that why you brought me here?
Oh!
You're here. You're here. They have you. I know you. I remember her from Ordinary. I thought I'd never see you again. Hang on, I'm coming.
So Hedron, as in dodecahedron, like a 20-sided dice. Is that dodecahedron? I've said that with such confidence.
I'm Dr. Casper Darling, and this is my final message.
Why are you not wearing anything, Casper?
It's not the end. But after this, I exposed myself to Hedron resonance fully. It is... It's changing me. I've seen... I've been shown so much. Slidescape 36 was where Hedron stopped the spread of another. It's terrifying. It really is. It's another source of resonance.
And that's what...
Trench was exposed to this other. It will now spread. I've done everything I can to stop the Hedron resonance amplifiers. I don't know if it'll make a difference. I won't be here when it happens. I should have told him anymore. I'm being sent one more lesson. Something wonderful, I think.
Huh. So, Hedron is Polaris, and that is why we... Yeah, that stuff is moving. So that's why we are immune to the hiss, because we have got Polaris in our head. We've got her resonance, or its resonance. But the Hedron resonance amplifiers work on the same frequency. And they are amplifying that resonance across the house. The slide projector only works with slide 36. Logically, this means the slide itself is a part of the object of power or a distinct altered item. But of course, I had to make sure no other slides worked. I had to try. I thought maybe emotion had something to do with it. Connection, history, love. I brought in my parents' old slides, birthday parties, vacations to Niagara Falls, my first day of school, that kind of thing. There were two boxes worth. I had to dig around the garage for an hour to pass them, to find them. Not once thought of looking at them since they passed. I tried them all. I waited until all the staff left for the night. I stayed up in that booth for hours, trying every one. Projector off, slide out, slide in, projector on, nothing happens. Projector off, slide out, slide in, projector on, nothing happens. Love wasn't the common factor. There's no correlation that I can see. Maybe the slide itself is the object of power. Maybe the projector's just an accessory. Maybe it doesn't matter. Why'd that kid have to burn the other slides? Why indeed? I guess then.
Through here? You are coming through so strong. Darling, use this HRA to lock the door. I have to rip it off to get in. Are you sure? Okay, I'll be there. Hang on.
I don't think this is a good idea. I think Polaris is going to be the bad guy, and the hiss is here to stop it.
I made it.
The hole in your room.
Uh-oh.
This was a mistake.
Yeah, seen it. Oh. Can't do that when we've been shot at.
Get the fuck away.
So, as expected. Now, these bloody things. Get out of here. Give me that health. Cleanse the siphons. I shall do so. They're trying to get in. Is it because they're trying to stop? I mean, it's possible that the story is as intended. I hit you with your friends! Where are you at? That is never not going to be entertaining. So yeah, the Hiss are trying to overpower the Resonance Farm Polaris. / Hedron. Oh, that's all of them. Oh, there we go. Gotta go up. Whee! That was not what I went to do, but... Blah! But it worked. Right. Oh, chair. I thought that was a chair boy for a second. I can't stand those. See, that's center mass. And it's- oh, hello. Die! Really don't like those enemies. They're just a little bit too nimble. Womp. Yeah. Oop. Can I make it over there? Can't ever do that. Gimme. And you. Oh, hello, senior operative. Oh, chair boys. Yeah, hiss nodes. That's totally what I want to be doing right now. You're dead. At least with this many enemies, we are getting an absolute ton of health. Hold on. I wonder what that was. Yeah, I think this is a bad idea. Nice shot. Don't say that to myself very often. Ouch. Great. Oh, how far back is this going to put us? Because that's the problem with the checkpoint system. Yeah, all the way back here. Is it going to have reset the fight entirely? No, at least it hasn't reset the fight entirely. It has reset it a bit, though. You can be mine. Asking you. I should probably put the sea speed mod on. Mom. Okay, so this is where we got to. Yeah, this is where we got to before, where everything went a little bit on the harsh side. So this time, I can't actually see any of the enemies from here. Can we get higher? I want some friends. You're not a friend. You're very much the opposite. Ooh, but you could be. Say hello to my little friend. Nice. Can't see its head from here. Uh-oh. I know there's a floaty boy coming around the corner. Yes. Oh! Ah! Alright, where are you? Right, is that all of them? No. Oh, wait, was this where we got to before? I'm kind of losing track.
Get the fuck away.
Yeah, this isn't working, Jesse. You didn't die. Accuracy bonus needed. Right. Right, get rid of you. Get rid of you, right. Normal grunts. Easy enough to deal with. Not with that aim, they're not. No, shit. But you're dead. You're dead. Oh. Come on, be my friend. I need the help. Oh, bollocks. Man, this is rough. Like, really rough. I'd love to just be able to knock him off the... off the edge. Like that. Oh, man. How much harder is this going to get? Jesse, language. Oh, I think that might be the end of the combat bit. Weapon mods full. Up. Up. Yeah, I think this is all,
No. The poster comes down and there's nothing there. It's just the cell and death. I was wrong. There was never anything there. Hello? Polaris, are you there?
What?
You are a worm through time. The thunder song distorts you. Happiness comes.
Uh-oh. What? Well, that's just weird. Not the end. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, why not click the like button and consider subscribing? Remember, you can ring the bell notification icon to get notified when new videos go live. And until next time, cheerio.